Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, today we are going to see a different type of molding, which is rotational molding, which are used to create hollow products. And how it is done, we are going to see the details of it. So in rotational molding, you can make hollow. Seamless article can be made, and also due to melting, heating, as well as sintering action. So making hollow objects, you use rotational device, which is rotating and doing a hole, which is hollow, and seamless process can be achieved. So it is generally used for producing hollow objects. So in this diagram, you can see the whole process. There is a cyclonic grinder which just grinds the particles so that many big particles, that is of a large size grains, cannot be transferred. That is transferred to the cyclone. It is grinding, re-grinded, then passing through the sieves, then to a mold, then to the bag. Excess air which is heated can be easily removed to the arrangement. In this way, rotational molding takes place. So I'll talk about the advantages of rotational molding. Design flexibility is a very basic and very additional added advantage in rotational molding. And also the parts you make are virtually stress-free material. Tooling is very easy and basic polymers can be easily produced in rotational molding process. Parts do not stick to the wall as it is rotating continuously. So thickness of the object which is desired can be easily obtained. Also, double walled parts can be made easily and insulation can also be provided to the parts in rotational molding process. Then I'll talk about the disadvantages. The parts which are made due to heat can be thicker or thinner but not as per the prescribed need. As the material is pulverized, only small particles can be made and powdered thing cannot be getting converted into other particles easily. Also, warpage of the material occurs during the cooling process. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ikeda and do subscribe our channel, Ikeda.